कृष्णवर्णं तिशाकृष्णं साङ्गोपाङ्गास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः सङ्कीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्ति सुमेधसः अन्तः कृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादिवैभवम् कलौ सङ्कीर्तनाद्यै स्मः कृष्णचैतन्यमाश्रिताः हितां मथुरा भूमौ श्रीलरूपसनातनौ यौ विलेखयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकद्ग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्याथ पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यश्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोजा भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतदन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमन्मन्त्रदेशिकमीश्वरं श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अथ नत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुम् यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमेयाति चिन्मात्रसत्ता यंसो यस्यांशकैस्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यं कृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम्। Absent is several. 1, 2, 3. Several students are absent. Exam, due to exam. How many absent? Is upside, upstairs. Coming. And only. Okay. I heard that many are absent for Sanskrit. Why? How many are absent? Raise the hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four? Only four. Okay. So you can message the reason why you are absent after the class. Okay, where we are? Page number 6, isn't this okay? So I hope all the devotees understood how the Shankaracharya's matam about the Purana and Itihasas is defeated. Understood? Shankaracharya, what he was saying? What is his vakya on the Madhyandina Sruti? According to him? Rangamai Prabhu? What is Shankara's bhashya on that?
Hare Krishna. Oh, Shankara told Vedas and
हाँ
Puranas, the
हाँ
Puranas are included in Vedas.
हाँ Puranas are included in Vedas. And what it mean? It means?
It means Puran and Vedas same.
Okay, and then that's good only, na?
No, no.
Why?
Because Puran also Veda, but it is different. Different yeah. scriptures. It is Veda.
So what is the damage is happening? If you say Puran and Itihasas are part of the four Vedas, are inside the four Vedas. If we accept like this, then what will happen? Sarveshwar Prabhu? Only one mic we have.
I don't know the exact reason, Baba. I'm assuming it. Maybe they will neglect the Itihasas and Puranas. Yes, Baba. People are not so intelligent, and there is, and they are not available.
Okay,
that's not the reason.
You try.
Well, because yeah. what they are saying is, what Shankaracharya is saying is that there are no Itihasas and Puranas outside of the four Vedas.
Yes.
So they're saying what you think as Puranas is not the Purana.
Ah,
Puranas
that is
are
that.
Already
that,
included in
that
the
is already
Vedas.
Inside the Vedas only.
Yeah.
So whatever you people are reading these 18 Puranas,
that's something extra.
And these are extra actually. So these are all not authentic. So that means what? By saying this, so ultimately, so he is just disproving the Bhagavatam and all 18 Puranas and Itihasas, everything out. So that means, so the major reference for establishing Lord, that is the Puranas actually. And that is now, so nobody is having faith on that. Even if you see in the most part of the India, many students, many people think that. So Purana Itihasas, these are all whatever are there. That means these 18 Puranas. These are written by the Vyasdev or someone they have written. So like this, they think. They think that it is written actually. They don't think these Puranas and Itihasas as Vedas. Like how the Vedas are eternally are coming from the Supreme Lord, they are Apaurushaya. In the same way, in the, with that same value, with the same respect, with the same understanding. So they don't have the on the Puranas and Itihasas. Yeah. Okay. Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah, just to help us, he has given, Vyasdev has given Puranas Itihasas.
Ah, but
we, the impression.
Yeah, this kind of impression is there in the common to the many people in the society. But it is not like that. Puranas and Itihasas are also Veda, like how the Vedas are coming directly from the Supreme Lord. So Puranas and Itihasas are also directly coming actually from his, when he exhaled. No, it's nothing less. So exact as Vedas are important and highly authentic, that much Puranas and Itihasas also authentic. Okay. So that's why if you, since our religion is, sorry, our philosophy is based upon the Bhagavatam. So many people say that, oh, what is this Bhagavatam? Your philosophy is based upon Bhagavatam. And it is not like the, that means it's not based upon the Upanishads. It's not, your philosophy is not fully based upon the Upanishads. That means your acharyas could have commented on the Upanishads and directly speaking on the from this you're deriving the philosophy, that should be done. So such a people say like that, some people. But so Puranas and Itihasas are also nothing less actually than the Vedas. What, Prabhu?
Puranas, there are stories like Mahabharata, Ramayana, and characters, patras are there.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Duryodhan, Bhishma, there are so many. So like they are eternal.
Yes.
Just like
roles are eternal.
So they are part of eternal. Part characters also eternal.
Characters are eternal, but jivas who are playing that, they are not eternal.
Okay, okay.
They are not permanently playing that same role.
Okay, okay.
So yeah. Next time, so someone will be the Duryodhan.
Okay.
So after that, some other one like the Indra is also now Purandar is the Irindra.
But
so
like
next
Bhishma
time,
and Pandavas, like they also.
But some are the eternal, like even the Lord's Leela, this
Arjun.
Golok Leela. So the Nitya Siddhas, whoever are there, like the Radharani, Srimati, and Gopigis, the Ashtasakis, all these are all eternal only. Those will be the same roles will be
like
there.
Bhishma and Pandavas.
Yes. Bhishma role can change. Bhishma role and Pandavas roles can, these can be changed. And Nara, I think Nara Arjuna's role will not be changing. Yeah, is not changing? Not changing. Okay, maybe. So, but some roles changes, some are eternal actually. Those only will come. Like Krishna's role is nobody is going to take. Krishna will be coming, Krishna only. So like that. So some are eternal and some are changing actually. But that role will be there, and in that role, the actor will be changing. Role will be the same role. Actress will be changing. And some roles, actress is not changing. Fixed. Fixed actually. Script actually. It's like a drama script. It's a fixed actually. So that's why Itihasas and Puranas are also Vedas. It's a Panchama Veda. It is there in the Bhagavatam also directly. In the third canto. In the 12th chapter, we were studying that. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yes, Maharaj.
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you. Again, about Shankaracharya, how does he justify his acceptance of Bhagavad Gita as part of Prasthanatraya? Yeah. And he writes a commentary on Bhagavad Gita, which is part of Mahabharata, yeah, which he does not accept as Veda. So how does he make that adjustment?
Yes, Maharaj, I am also having this doubt actually. Same doubt I am also having. Just I got that also. How he justified this, because Prasthanatrayam, he is taking the Bhagavad Gita, which is part of the Mahabharata. So if he is not accepting whole Mahabharata authentic, so then how he is justifying this? So maybe otherwise he might be considering that all. But I cannot speculate, but I will find actually, Maharaj. I don't know clearly. Yeah, the same doubt I am also having. Which Mataji? Yes, Mata. Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Pranams, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, we saw that in Vedas, everything is pre-written and the roles are also written. They are not changing, and everything, whatever is going to happen, it's happening in every yuga in the same sequence.
Yes,
but
yes.
Sometimes the acharyas give different interpretation and they say this happened in a different kalpa, this happened. So how do we take that, Prabhuji? For example, Damodar Leela itself, if you take, yeah, there are various variations given by different acharyas. And yes. And the same way, Govinda, Krishna is called Govinda by Lord Brahma or, yes, by Lord, by Surabhi Kau. The differentiation is there, no, Prabhuji. So how do we take it?
Yes, these differentiations are also there. Everything is there in the Veda. So all these changes are also there in the Veda. So it's not that the Veda is explaining only one type of Damodar Leela. It is explaining the various kinds of the Damodar Leela. So because Lord can be having the minor changes. So in the next Kalpa or in the some other Kalpa, those are all also there in the Vedas. So everything is there in the Veda. Yeah. So Veda is not saying only one type of Damodar Leela. So whatever changes are there, those are also there in that. Yeah. Okay, today we'll continue our... laptop sahi hai pura. Okay, welcome. Start book class will start. So in the, and also yesterday we discussed the total Vedas. Initially it is Yajurveda, and based upon the purpose, that means we took, that means four different kinds of the karma is there in performing yajna. That is the advaryam, audgatam karma, and hotram karma, brahmatvam karma, advaryam, audgatram. So there are different kinds of the karma is there in the yajna. So the mantras related to that karma are taken out from the Yajurveda, and those are set as four different Vedas. Then after that, whatever remaining in that Puranas and Itihasas, that means Akyanas, Upakyanas and Gathas, these things are taken out from that, that means in the Yajurveda, and compiled as Puran Itihasas. So here actually 100 crores of slokas are there in original, but we are not taking the 100 crores of the slokas. Only 4 lakh we took, and remaining thing is left there only. So as they only 4 lakhs he did. So that, what is the proof for that? That is in the Matsya Purana, it is said that. So original Purana Itihasa is the 100 crores. In that only 4 lakh, that means the summary of the 100 crores is a 4 lakh. And that much he took, and remaining he kept back. Yachishtam tu Yajurvede. It is Shastrardha Niranayaha. So that's why in the material, in the earthly planet, so we will be having the only, so 4 lakhs of these. Puranithyasas. Next, we'll be going further. Tathaiva. Question hai kya? Puchhiye.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes Prabhu.
Thanks for allowing me to ask. So Prabhu, this is the repeat question which couple of times have been asked, and I have like some understanding, and I just want your light on that understanding. So one of the questions, Prabhu, is that all the ornaments which are made from gold, we know the source is gold itself.
Yes.
So whatever shape ornament takes, it doesn't matter, the source will be same.
Yes.
So Smritis and Puranas are Veda themselves, right?
Yes.
And Adi Shankaracharya said that they are within the Veda itself.
Yes.
So with the example I said earlier, Prabhu, this logic seems correct. That they are not separate entity, they have to be Veda itself. Because if they are not Veda itself, if they are not contained within Veda, they cannot talk about Veda itself.
Yes.
So that was the one inference, Prabhu. The second part is that we are saying, Sri Jiva Goswami Ji is saying that they are the fifth Veda.
Yes.
Right. Yes. So which means it's to me, it understands it is, it's a continuity of Veda. However, it's a continuity of the Veda, which was not covered in those four parts and is a separate piece which makes full Veda. Now, these two ways of seeing this is confusing, because if it is a continuity and it is making the full Veda by saying it as a fifth Veda, then it cannot talk about the first four parts of it. Because we are saying it's a separate Veda. And if it's a separate Veda and they all are Veda, then that fifth part has to have its own entity, has to have its own identity. So this is the Prabhu where I am kind of caught up. If you can throw your light on this understanding.
Okay. Okay, Prabhu. So fifth Veda... So if I understand correctly, so that what you are saying, this fifth Veda, that means Itihasas and Puranas, so they, if they are continuation of the Vedas, then they should carry the separate information. You want to say like this?
Yes, Prabhu.
Separate information. Okay. So actually here, what we are understanding from the Jiva Goswami's explanation, this Itihasas Puranas, that means are compiled with the Gathas and Akhyanas and Upakhyanas. So this part of the Veda is also explaining the same what is there in the four Vedas, but with the different style. That four parts are may especially having the mantras, Brahmana, Aranyaka, and Upanishads. That four Vedas are each is having that kind of four divisions. So that's why, example, if you take in the four Vedas, there is a about the chanda is there in any about the chanda, how many rules are there. So that is explained in the four Vedas. The chanda is explained in the four Vedas. That same thing, chanda rules are also explained in these Puranas are also. Like example, so the positions of the sun or otherwise different rasis about the cosmology. So about the cosmology, it is explained in that Vedas through the mantras and others. That information is there. And in these Purana Itihasas are also the same cosmological, that means cosmology is explained here also in this. So like this, in that four parts, Brahman is also explained in the Upanishads, absolute truth. The same absolute truth is also explained here in the Puranas. So that means like this, you will be seeing there is also there, here also there. And here it is, what is the advantage? This Puranas and Itihasas, they are very easy to understand because their language, that means is not having the Swarakrama Bheda. So Swarakrama, Swaras are not used. That means Udhatta, Anudhatta, Swarita, Ityadi. So these are all not used. So that complexity is reduced in the Puranas and Itihasas. So that's why this become very easy to understand. But we are getting the, so whatever the knowledge we are getting from the four Vedas, that is all, everything we are also getting here.
So with this explanation, Prabhu, then Shankaracharya Bhashya looks correct that these four, these Smriti and Puranas are within Vedas.
But he is saying, what he is saying, instead of saying that these are separate from the four Vedas, he is concluding, that means he is saying that these Puranas and Itihasas are not there at all. That means what we have now, 18 Puranas, he is not considering these. Those are already there in the inside only.
So that's what we are saying as well, Prabhu, isn't it? Like, yeah. If because what we are saying is this fifth Veda is nothing but the simplified form of what is already there, right? And he is saying it is there, and that is truth as well, because this fifth Veda doesn't have its separate identity. It is talking about the same content in a simplified form.
How can you say that is inside? Because if it is inside, then why can you say it is simplified and that is a complex? How can you say this?
So this is Prabhu we were discussing earlier. Because if it is talking about Veda, then it is already inside. Because we gave example of that gold, any jewelry coming out of it, taking any shape, simple or complex, has to be the gold because it is coming from that source. So anything talking about that source, whether it is simple or complex, it is already in the source. It just we are trying to understand it. So his bhasya, I'm not able to, what we say to is like, I'm not able to logically say that what he's saying is not appropriate.
So your logic is not there, what you are speaking. So first of all, what I'm saying, you try to understand. Okay, so what I am saying, this Purana and Itihasas are not the part of the four Vedas. That means they are having the difference. What is the difference? Swarabheda. Okay, Swarabheda is there in the Purana Itihasas. Swara following the Swaras is there in the Puranas and Itihasas. It is not there, na? So then how can you say both are same? Both are not same. The difference, if you take the Shankaracharya's philosophy, that means understanding about the Puranas and Itihasas, then where is the difference? How can you bring out the difference?
So, Prabhu, you are talking about the grammar. When you say these, you know, swaras and other thing, these are the grammar. I'm kind of questioning the content itself. So that's where I am focusing.
What you are saying, there is no, like you discuss after the class.
Okay. It just, I thought that, you know, you can lighten my, oh, I will.
No. Actually, you are not getting Prabhu properly. So you are going the off track actually.
Okay, Prabhu. Then we will go later.
Yes.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Tathaiva darshitam veda saha bhavena shiva puranasya vayaviya samhitayam. Sankshipya chaturo vedams chaturdha vyabhajat prabhuhu vyasta veda tayakhyato veda vyasa iti smritaha. Puranamapi sankshiptam chaturlaksha pramanatah adhyapyamartya loketu satakoti pravistharam. Where is that? Any 7, huh? The Puranas. After considering the 4 Vedas, he compiled the 4 Vedas. He is known as Vedavyas. First he considered, then after that he compiled. That's why he is known as Vedavyas. Sankshipya Chatur Vedas Chaturda Vyabhachat Prabhu. Vyasta Vedataya Khyato Veda Vedavyasa Iti Smritaha. So how he divided that whole philosophy, I explained. Yes. So initially one Yajurveda is there. So from there, so what he did? So based upon the activity, that means 4 kinds of activities are there in the Yajna. Based upon that, so different mantras are taken out and 4 Vedas are arranged. Then after that, whatever the stories and the sub-stories and gathas, histories are there, those all compiled as 5th. So is there any difficulty in this and understanding? No. What is the problem actually? So it's clearly said here how to divide also the mechanism he explained. On what basis Vedavyas divided the 4 is clearly said. So what is the difficulty in this? So then... After that, what he did? Puranam api sankshiptam chaturlaksha pramanata. Of course, Puranas and Itihasas are all 100 crores. But out of that 100 crores, he took only 4 lakhs. And remaining thing, he kept there only. Yes, system, yajurvede. Whatever is remaining, that is kept back. So, adhyapi amartya loke satakoti pravistaram. Even now also, even in the non... That means other than this mortal world. So there are Amartya, non-earth planet. So there are 100 crores of verses are there. That kind of Puranam is there. Ityatra teneti sheshaha. So that means we have to take tena sankshiptam. Next. Skandam Agneyam Ityadi Samakhyastu Pravachana Nibandhana Katakadivat Anupurvi Nirmana Nibandhana Va. So the Puranas were condensed by Vyasa, Skanda and Agni Puranas are also called because they were spoken by Skanda and Agni, but were written by Vyasa, just as the Kataka refers to parts of the Veda studied by Katha. So that's the names. Then Puranas are 4 lakhs. Now that is once again divided into 18 parts. 4 lakhs of verses are divided into 18 parts. So on what name, how the naming is given, one may get doubt. So the name is based upon that, means who is speaking that Purana. So based upon that, Skanda is speaking, then it is known as Skanda Purana. And Agni is speaking, then that is known as Agni Purana. Like that, some rules he kept, and based upon that, he divided. Like the, we see the Upanishads also divided, like Kataka Upanishad. So like this. Or otherwise, sometimes you can take because of the successive order of production. So that means first Brahmaji, and after that next Padma Purana, Brahma Purana. That means creation. That means he might be following the some sequence of the activities, and based upon that, Puranas are also categorized. So either of the principles he followed, and he did. Much details are not given here. So this is the, just how the naming of Puranas is given is said here. Tasmat kvachit anityatvam sravanam tu avirbhava tirobhava pekshaya. So therefore, sometimes we may hear that the Puranas are not eternal. This is said based on appearance and disappearance of the Puranas. In this way, the Vedatvam of Itihasa Puranas is accomplished. So here, what we are hearing, sometimes we hear that Puranas and Itihasas are not eternal. Anityatva Saranam, that means not eternal. We may hear sometime like this. So that is because of what? That is because of just avirbhava tirobhava apekshaya. Just appearing and disappearing. By seeing that, one may say it is not eternal. That means they are appearing and disappearing. But actually they are not finished. So like the pot you showed, and after that you kept inside the room, and there is no pot now in the room. So it is kept inside, and now in the room, it is not in front of now, pot is not there. That means appearing and disappearing only, Puranas and Itihasas. It's not that they are finished. Tadevam Itihasa Purana Yoho Vedatvam Siddham. So like this, Vedatvam of the Itihasas and Puranas are established or accomplished. That means Itihasa Puranas are all also Vedas. It's a Panchama Veda. We should accept this as Panchama. It is not inside the 4 Vedas. And one may think that these are all inside the 4 Vedas. That is a wrong interpretation. That's an ill interpretation. Just to destroy the existence of the present Purana and Itihasas. So intentionally that is did. So that is not correct. Because already we have enough proof for this.
Tathapi sutadinam adhikaraha sakala nigamavalli sattvala krishna namavat.
Then one may raise the objection. If it is a Veda, then why is Suta and others, they have qualification to recite this? One may ask this. Vedas are should be read by the only Dvijas. Now you are saying Itihasa Puranas are it's a Vedas. Then Dvijas only should read this. Then why Sota Goswami is reading this? Why Sota Goswami is teaching this? Why Sota Goswami is studying this? Objection is raised. Yeah. Hurupakshi came. Tathapi Sota Adina. But what is the answer for this? It is like the holy name. It is like the holy name. Of course, holy name is there in the Vedas or not? Krishna name. Is there? Krishna name is there in the Vedas? Yes. And still everyone is eligible for that or not? Yes. Similarly, like the same way, Puranas and Itihas are also eligible for everyone. The same way. Like how the holy name is, everyone is eligible to take the holy name in the same way. Puranas and Itihas are also. Tathapi Sutadi Nam Adhikaraha Sakala Negamavalli Satvala Sri Krishna Namavat. Where is it? Although Puranas or Veda, Suta and others are also eligible for this because it is like the name of Krishna, which is the fruit of the creeper of all the Vedas. That means Krishna holy name. Holy name is the what? Is the fruit. Sakala Nigama Valli Satfala. Holy name is the ripened fruit of the Vedas. These are the Vedas. For these Vedas, this is fruit. What fruit this is? Mango. This is holy name, Krishna. Whatever you like, you can assume that fruit. Okay. So this is the fruit. That means this is Veda and this is essence of all the essence of tree is what? Is the fruit. Essence of the all the Vedas is the holy name. So everyone, even of course, it is the fruit of the Vedic tree. So it is still eligible. Everyone is eligible for this or not. So similarly, so Vedas. So in that, this. Yeah. This Itihasas and Puranas, this is the portion, the total Vedas, and these are four Vedas, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is fifth Veda. Like he, essence of everything is holy name. This is eligible for everyone. Then what is the problem if you say it is eligible for everyone? Is there any problem for you? Since they are not eligible for everyone, in the Bhagavatam commentary you will be seeing today, we'll be discussing for first canto, fourth chapter in that. These Vedas are not, so these, that means that we should satisfy that also. Vedas are eligible for the Dvijas. That means these four Vedas are eligible for the Dvijas. Okay. This one is for everyone. If it is the insight to this only, it is not separately, then Purana Itihasa Sar should not be chanted by anyone. If you give that kind of commentary, then there is problem here also. That means Purana Itihasa should not be chanted. But we all know Purana Itihasa can be chanted by the everyone. Yathoktam prabhasa khande Madura Madura Metan Mangalam Mangalanam Sakala Negamavalli Satvala Chitswarupam Sakrudapi Parigitam Sridaya Helaya Bhruguvara Naramatram Tarayet Krishna Nama. This is what? How can you say holy name is ripened fruit of the Vedas? That is there in this Prabhasakanda, Skanda Purana. What is that? Madura Maduram Etat Mangalam Mangalanam సకల నిగమవల్లి సత్ఫలం చిత్ స్వరూపం. హోలీ నేమ్ ఈజ్ చిత్ స్వరూపం, ఈజ్ ప్యూర్ ట్రాన్సెండెంటల్, ఈజ్ ప్యూర్లీ ట్రాన్సెండెంటల్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద రైపన్ ఫ్రూట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది వేదాస్. సకృదపి పరిగీతం, ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ వన్ టైమ్ శ్రద్ధయా హేలయ, దట్ మీన్స్ విత్ ఫుల్ అటెన్షన్ ఆర్ అదర్వైజ్ జస్ట్ సార్కాస్టికల్లీ, భృగువరా, ఓ భృగువర్, హూ ఈజ్ దట్ భృగువర్, శ్రవణక్, నరమాత్రం తారయేత్ కృష్ణనామ, ఇట్ విల్ డెలివర్ ఎవ్రీవన్, ఇట్ విల్ డెలివర్. వై వై ద హోలీ నేమ్ కెన్ డూ లైక్ దిస్ ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ ది వితౌట్ ప్రాపర్ అటెన్షన్, still that is also is without knowing meaning. Sankhetyam parihasyam stobam helanam cha, that means even sarcastically, jokingly, if you take also, even if you take the holy name jokingly also, it will be purifying you. Why Because this holy name, what? Chit Swarupam. It is what? Transcendental. And also this holy name is non-different from the Krishna. That is, it is of the Swarupa Shakti. It is of the Swarupa Shakti. That means what? It is what? Swayam Prakashaha. So wherever it goes, it doesn't need of any other's help to illuminate. Even that doesn't need of the process and conditions of the process. Irrespective of the process and condition of the process, it will immediately work. Like you take a lamp, any room you will take, irrespective of the conditions, it will just throw away the darkness. Similarly, this holy name is completely self-illuminating. That means it is not dependent on any other one, even on the process also, even on the person also. Even person doesn't know the meaning, no matter. Holy name meaning he may not know, but it's no matters, because that is self-illuminating. Swayam Prakashaha. So that's why we say, that's why Sanketyam Parihasyam Sthobam Helanamacha, that sloka is, that's why it is said. So any condition if you take, it will immediately, who is saying this? Sanatana Goswami? Sanketyam? సాంకేత్యం పారిహాస్యం వా స్తోభం హేళనమేవ వా వైకుంఠనామగ్రహణం అశేషాగహరం విదుః. ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ ఎనీ స్టేజ్, ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ సమ్ హోర్ అదర్ హోలీ నేమ్, ఇట్ విల్ డిస్ట్రాయ్ ఆల్ ద క్లేశాగ్ని, దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ ఫినిష్ ఆల్ ద సిన్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ హ్యావ్. హూ ఇస్ సేయింగ్ దిస్? విష్ణుదూతాస్ ఆర్ సేయింగ్. విష్ణుదూతాస్ ఆర్ సేయింగ్ ఇన్ ద అజామిల్ స్టోరీ. So this is the power actually. Tarayet Krishna Nama. So now here the main point is, this holy name is the ripened fruit of the Vedas. So how it is, everyone is eligible for taking that. Similarly, Itihasa Puranas are also. యథోక్తం విష్ణు ధర్మే ఋగ్వేదోయం యజుర్వేద ఋగ్వేయం ఋగ్వేదోయం యజుర్వేద సామవేదోప్యథర్వణః అదీతాస్తేన యేనోక్తం హరిరిత్యక్షరద్వయం. Where is that answer? Okay. He who recites the two syllables, Hari. Hari ityaksharadvayam adhitasthena, you know. So that has studied the Rig, Yajus, Sama and Atharva. How can you say this holy name is the ripened fruit of all the Vedas? Because this is one more proof. So such a holy name is can be taken by everyone. Then what is the problem of taking the this fifth part of the? Atha Vedhartha Nirnayakatvam cha Vaishnave Bharatavyapadeshena Hyamna Yartha Pradarshitaha Vedah Pratishtita Sarve Purane Natra Samshayaha Ityadav Bharatavyapadeshena. Okay, you have to open new. This file is finished, na? Prabhu? Is there? In the same one? Where we discussed this. Why I am studying the new one. You open, all open the new file. Yeah. WhatsApp just now I did. So that file you open. Mahasaya Prabhu, ask what is point. Hey, password change ho gaya kya?
Two quick question.
Internet Wi-Fi password change? Bula. Because all other also using, I think that's why he changed. All students are using, na? One second, I will download my file. 2 minutes, sir. Bulaiye unko.
Can I ask?
Prabhu, yes, Prabhu, yes, you can ask question.
Prabhu, Prabhas Khande means that part of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Prabhu?
Prabhas Khande means Bhagavatam.
No. It is in Skanda Purana.
Skanda Purana. And Prabhuji, when you said Skanda Purana and Agni Purana, so they discuss different parts or same parts also, or overlap is there?
Same parts means?
Means Skanda Purana and Agni Purana, like you said, like there are two. So then they discuss different topics, or the topics can be overlapping or same topic?
No. The naming, how it is given. So Puranas are 4 lakhs. Now, once again, those divide into 18 types, 18 divisions, and also named Skanda, Agni, and like that. Okay. So, on what basis they are given the names, that was discussed. Because Skanda was saying, that's why it is known as Skanda Purana. And Agni was speaking, that's why it is known as Agni Purana.
Yes, thank you.
He's coming? He forgot the password. नहीं आ रहे, देखो पासवर्ड ये रिसर्च करेगा ये। Okay, wait, otherwise OnePlus 6, who's this network? Give me the net for 2 minutes, I can download. Hare Krishna is not there. Radha Madhav is there. Okay. Okay, leave it, you should do research later. फाइल है ना? अच्छा, इट्स नॉट हैविंग वायरस, चलेगा ना? शो मी द फाइल। ये नया है, आ गया, आ गया। वेट वेट, माय लैपटॉप इज लाइक दैट। And how will you use mouse? Mouse will not work there. ये भी गए क्या? प्रभु Yes. Radha Madhu. type change. Even he will change later. Unable to connect. Wait. आ गया, आ गया। ये है ना? ओके। अथ वेदार्थ निर्णायकत्वं वैष्णवे भारतव्यपदेशेन आम्नायार्थः प्रदर्शितः वेदाः प्रतिष्ठिताः सर्वे पुराणे नात्र संशयः। भारतव्यपदेशेन आम्नायार्थः प्रदर्शितः, आम्नायार्थः मीन्स् वेदार्थः, द मीनिङ्ग्स् आफ् आल् द वेदास् आर् पब्लिश् आर् दि शोन् एस् भारत महाभारत मीन्स वेदाः प्रतिष्ठिताः सर्वे पुराणे नात्र संशयः। ऑल द वेदास आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द पुराणास, देयर इज नो डाउट इन दैट। सो पुराणास एसर्टेन द मीनिंग ऑफ द वेदास एज सेड इन विष्णु पुराण, दो द कंपाइलेशन ऑफ महाभारत द मीनिंग ऑफ द वेदास वाज शोन, ऑल द वेदास आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द पुराणास विदाउट डाउट। ओके दिस, सो दैट मीन्स व्हाट, ऑल द पुराणास आर the all the Vedic information, whatever the Vedic Vedas are dealing subject matter, that is everything is there in the Puranas. But it is in the very simplified manner. Ityadau kinchaha. Kinchaha. Vedartha Deepakanam Shastranam Madhyapatitabhyupagame Api Avirbhavaka Vaishishtya Tayoreva Vaishishtyam. Avirbhavaka Vaishishtyat. What is the point we are hearing? Avirbhavakaha. So let us take. There are these so many scriptures are there to illuminate the meanings of Vedas. Vedartha Deepakanam. Example. So there are so many Smriti Shastras are there. So many Kamsama Agama Shastras are there. Or some other works, Tantra Shastras are there. And Vedanta Sutras are there. And also some Shat Darshanas are there. They are all there to illuminate the meanings of the Vedas. So, and they are all given by the various Acharyas. Various Acharyas compiled those. Like the Tantra, Narada Panch Tantra. So, it is done by, it is compiled by the, it is written by the Narada Muni. And Smriti Shastra, Manu Smriti is there. It's written by the Manu. So like the, they are all also carrying the Vedic information only. They are all also illuminating the meanings of Vedas only. So like that Purana Saitihas are also there. These Vedas and Vedas are illuminated by many Shastras. Vedartha Deepikas. We call them as Vedartha Deepakanam. That means Deepaka means illuminator. Of the what? Vedartha. This is Veda. The meaning of Veda is illuminated by all these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that, so many are there. Example is Tantras, Smritis, and like this if you take, so some Darshan Shastras. So Darshan Shastras, everything will come in this. Mimamsa, everything. So like this, now Puranas are also there. And Purana Itihasas. These are the four Vedas. The meanings of four Vedas are illuminated by all these. So then, if you see, who is the... Next, what is said? Out of this, Avirbhavakaha. Madhyapatitabhyupagame. So, Avirbhavaka. If you consider Itihasa Purana is the one among the illuminators of Vedic meanings. If you consider Itihasa Puranas are also as one among the illuminators of meanings of Vedas. Okay? Then, who is the author of this Avirbhavakaha? Means author. Who is the author? Vedavyas. And this is this darshanas, other darshanas is done by the Jaimini, Gautam, and so on. And Smriti Shastra Manu. And this is Tantras are example. Few examples you can give, like Narada and this. So among the Avirbhavakas, that means the propounders or otherwise the compiling persons who are or person caused to appear those. In if you see in that, who is special? Vedavyas. With respect to, with that respect also, if you see, Vedavyas is supreme to all others. So that's why in that way also you can think, that means you can take, these Itihasa Puranas are all very special. That means what? One may say, finally, why you are struggling? You are, so one may say that, you want the, now we established Vedas, as that means non-defective Shabda is what you established. non-defective shabda is Vedas we established. So now, to illuminate the meanings of the Vedas, so many are there. Why will you take only Purana Itihasa? So other also are there. They are also illuminating or expressing the meanings of the Vedas. You may take that. So now we are saying, even if you see the authors of these, in that among all the authors of all these, the Vedavyas is a supremely special. In that way, that means we are just adding one more point. Why we are taking only Purana Itihasas to say this? We are adding one more point because Vedavyas is author for this or otherwise compiler for this. So that's why in that way also these Purana Itihasas are more appropriate. That means we should take Purana Itihasas in the place of Vedas as non-defective shabda. Madhyapatita means if falling among them, if Purana and Itihasas are accepted. Abhyupagama means accepting. That means Purana Itihasas are all accepted. Purana Itihasas are accepted as one among the Shastras, Darshan, Deepika Shastras. That means the Shastras which illuminate the Vedic meanings. But if you accept, that means general, you are seeing now Purana Itihasa instead of as a Panchama Veda, you are seeing just as it is an illuminator, it is expressing the meanings of Vedas. In that way, if you see also, since the author of the Purana Itihasa is Vyasadeva, so that's why it is very special only compared to others. Stood? Understood. Vaishishtyam. So how can you say Vedavyas is very special than other authors? Yatha Padme, it is said in the Padma Purana. Dvaipayanena yadbuddham brahmadyaistanna budyate sarvam buddham savaiveda tadbuddham nanya gocharaha. What Padma Purana is saying? What is known by Vyasadev is not known by Brahma and others. You are understanding? He knows that which is known to everyone, and no one knows what is known to him. He knows that which is known to everyone. That means whatever everyone knows, that he knows everything, that completely. And whatever he knows, we don't. Others don't know. Yeah. Even he is a master, actually. Sometimes disciples are superior to the... yes or no? If otherwise, then how? Every time it is only one order, then... So then by the time the disciples' assistant will be weak. Huh? So master is only always superior and disciple is lesser than him and lesser than him, lesser than him, lesser than him. Then after that sometime, disciple is finished. So this Narada, of course, he is, Vedavyas is a disciple of Narada, but he is knowing that much. Even Brahmaji also not knowing. He is Narayana actually. That's why. Next, skande vyasa chitta stita akashad avachinnani kani chit anye vyavaharantye tan uri krutya gruhadiva. In the Skanda Purana it is said, other sages accept and use some portion of the knowledge from the vast sky of total knowledge, which is situated in Vyasa's heart, like taking and using objects from a house. Like if you want to prepare one sabji, you are taking the ingredients from the storeroom and bringing and you are using. Like that, total story is what? the heart of the Vyasadeva. And other rishis, what they are doing? They are taking some portion of that and they are just establishing their own school. So that's why, since Vyasadeva is giving the Purana Itihasas, he is compiling. That's why they are very special. Atthaiva drishtam Sri Vishnu Purane Parasharavakyam. So how we are going, whole flow is, you are remembering now, flow is okay? Flow is clear? So yeah. Why and suddenly all of a sudden why we are discussing Vyasadeva? You understood, na? Why, Prabhu? Huh? Why Vyasadeva? We are discussing Vyasadeva. Why we are discussing about Vyasadeva? Tell me.
He wrote all the Purana scripture on Veda, that Itihasas.
Yeah.
Itihas is one part of the Veda.
So yeah. Now we are, what we are doing, Itihasas and Puranas. So we are comparing, or we are treating that as one among the scriptures which give the meanings of Vedas. So in that way we are thinking, and those other scriptures are authors of the other scriptures are so some and so and so. But among those authors, who is the best? Is the Vyasadeva. That means Vyasadeva being the best author among the authors of the scriptures which illuminate or the which gives the meanings of the Vedas. Next. Tatotra matsuto vyasa ashtavimshati mentare vedamekam chatushpadam chaturtha vyabhajat prabhuh yathatra tena vaivyastha vedavyasena dhimata vedastatha samastair tair vyasair anyaistatha maya tadanenaiva vyasanam shakha bedan dijotama chaturyugeshu rachitan samasteshvavadharaya krishna dvaipayanam vyasam viddhi narayanam prabhu konyo hi bhuvi maitreya mahabharata krut bhavet ko anyaha bhuvi he maitrey mahabharata krut bhavet. Who can become the compiler of such a vast Mahabharat? That can be only one. That is, who can become? Vedavyas. Yeah, Parasara is speaking to Maitreya. No questions. Time waste just. So here, Vishnu Purane, in the 28th Manvantara, my son Vyasa divided the one Veda of four parts into four Vedas, just as the Vedas were compiled by intelligent Vyasa. The other Vyasas have also done this, including me. O best of the Brahmana, understand that in all cycles of four yugas, there are different branches of the Vedas produced by other Vyasas. Know that Krishna Dvaipayana Vyasa is Lord Narayana, O Maitreya, who else can become compiler of Mahabharata on earth? So he like this, Parasara is saying, Matsutaha Vyasaha Ashtavimshati Tamayantare. Vyasadeva is appearing in, that means Lord himself, Krishna Dvaipayan, Lord Sri Krishna himself is appearing as Vyasadeva in which Manvantara? In the Vaivastha Manvantara Ashtavimshati. That means cycle, 28th cycle. So Vyasadeva is also appearing. So Vedamekam Chatushpadam Chaturda Vyabhajat. Yathatra Tena Ve Vyastaha Vedavyasena Dhimata. 20th cycle of the 20th cycle of Chaturyugas. So in the Vaivastha Manvantara. No. Jivas will be the Vedavyas. But here, this Vyasadev is Lord Narayana. That's why he is known as Krishna Dvaipayan. Krishna Dvaipayanam Vyasam Viddi Narayanam Prabhum. He is Narayana himself. He is Narayana himself. That means in other Manvantara, in other cycles, whoever is coming, they are not Narayana actually. Parasara is telling to Maitreya in Vishnu Purana. In the 28th, actually cycle, thoda sa spelling mistake. It's not spelling, it is translation mistake. 28th Manvantara, how it is possible? Only 14 Manvantara, sir. and sloka is right only. Antare means in the Manvantara. Ashta Vimshati Tame. That means in the 28th cycle. Little mistake is there in the... Definitely it is a mistake. It is not mentioned sloka, but today we will be seeing in the Bhagavata it is mentioned by the Viswanath. 1.4.14. Viswanath Chakra Thakur is mentioning. 7th Manvantara only. Vaivasvata. Vedam ekam chatushpadam chaturdha vyabhajat prabhuhu. One Veda is divided into four. Just as Vedas are compiled by intelligent Vyasa, the other Vyasas have also done this, including me. That means some other time, Parasara also will become Vyasadev. That means others are also, they are doing the Vyasadev means what? Vyasa means whoever is dividing is known as Vyasa. Like how others are also doing. And he will also do. Different branches of the Vedas produced by other Vyasas. So know that Krishna Dvaipayan Vyasa is, that means in the Vyasas, Krishna Dvaipayan Vyasa is Lord Narayana directly. Is Narayana himself. So konyo hi bhuvi maitreya mahabharata krut. That means who can become the compiler of Mahabharata. That means no other authors can become compiler of Mahabharata. Only Vyasa can become. No other authors. Skanda eva. Narayana. Vinishpan Narayanad Vinishpannam Gnanam Krutayuge Stitam Kinchidanyatha Jatam Tretayam Dvaparekhilam Gautamasya Rushesya Padjane Tu Gnanatam Gate Sankirna Buddha Yove Deva Brahma Rudra Purasara Sharanyam Sharanam Jagmur Narayanamanamayam Tair Vignapita Karyastu Bhagavan Purushottama Avatirno Mahayogi Satyavatyam Parasharat Utsannan Bhagavan Vedan Ujjahara Hari Swayam Ujjahara Harihi Swayam. Quickly we'll read the translation. Nothing much is there in this. So in the Satyuga, knowledge produced from the Narayana was present. All this which underwent slight change was present in the Treta and Dwapara Yugas. When because of a curse of Gautama, knowledge turned into ignorance, less intelligent devatas headed by Brahma and Rudra took shelter of pure Narayana, the shelter of the surrendered. By their request, the Supreme Lord, the great yogi, appeared through Parasara in the womb of Satyavati and recovered the Vedas, which were lost. Okay. Gautama did the curse. That's why knowledge is disappeared. So then after that, once again, so this Mahayogi, Yogi, this Vedavyas appeared and he is revived back. Story, yes, we'll tell in the next class. I will tell the story. Full story is there actually. Okay, questions? On site. Questions should be appropriate, proper, and asking questions also, there is a one science actually. We should know how to ask the questions, and also we should know how to frame the questions. And questions should be in the way of understanding, not in the way of challenging. Okay. So that is very important to, in the, as a student, one has to maintain this. One should not get that. Another way of feelings actually.
Roji, yeah. In different kalpa, sometimes just like Vyas and Krishna comes, Krishna Dvaipara and Vyas came, this Vyasat Manu, 28th. So I want to know, when I heard whenever Krishna comes, the original Golok Vrindavan descends. Other time Vishnu Narayan comes. So in that time, Vrindavan, it is a Vaikuntha comes, yeah, Vishnu comes.
Yeah.
But that time Vishnu, he Krishna only plays the pastimes here. So I want to know Vaikuntha and original Golok Vrindavan and other Golok Vrindavan is there, like Vaikuntha. How do you understand this?
I'm not clear about your question. So Golok Vrindavan is the highest Vaikuntha. Okay. The topmost Vaikuntha, okay, is known as.
So whenever Krishna comes in, Krishna not every day, once a day of Brahma.
Once in a Brahma's day.
Every Yuga Krishna comes. Krishna comes in, the Vishnu comes, not original Krishna comes.
Yes.
So that time Vrindavan also manifests whenever that Vishnu comes.
No. Then actually, but, so this Golok Vrindavan, we only Krishna, when he comes, at the time only it will be appearing.
Okay.
So then others are coming. So then the partial of that is manifesting. So that means whatever the features are there in the Krishna, that many features. See, it is simple, Prabhu. Whenever some avatara is coming, Krishna is 100%, and any avatara is descending. So out of that means 100, maybe some 90 or 80, that means percent of Shakti is manifested. Then in the same way, in the Goloka also, that much only is manifesting. Yeah, I understood, Prabhu, your question. So the answer is, so whoever is coming, that means Krishna is not directly coming, but he might be entering into the Narayana, and then he is performing the Leelas. So then that means how much portion is manifesting, that means as a Narayana. Narayana means how much energy is manifesting as Narayana is some portion of the Krishna out of 100. So that much only Loka also will manifest. That is in other yugas, yeah, we have to check. I am not so much clear. Yeah.
Hare Krishna, yeah. I have a question.
Yeah, yeah.
This Vyasdev, question is every Kali Yuga, are every Kali Yuga Vedas are lost? And somebody has to become Vyasadeva to make the Veda?
Yes.
Every equally.
Every time it happens. Yeah.
In previous Anucheda Pro, it was stated, there was one objection that this Puranas are Pancham Veda.
Yeah.
And so how Suta Goswami is eligible to read them?
How?
So Suta Goswami is eligible to read them because they are Vedas. So.
Yeah,
and Vedas are eligible only for the Dvijas.
Dvijas, yes.
So what Suta Goswami was not Dvija?
Suta was not Dvija, na?
What he was means?
So he is a Suta only. He is not the comes under the three. That means Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisya. He is not coming in that.
Oh, he was out of the.
He is not in the three Varnas. He is a Suta. Sutta. Yeah, there's a caste actually that is also.
Oh yeah.
Not Sudra. It's a Sutta is a one caste actually.
Outcast.
It's one of the Sankara actually. When they Viloma or Pratiloma of the is different Varanas, so that will become. Karana is that is his caste is that is a Sutta actually. That's caste is Sutta. Is one caste there when primary castes are four, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisya, Sudra. When Brahmana and the Kshatriya, that means Brahmana, Kshatriya man is marrying the Brahmana girl, so that is a Viloma. That is then that Varna is known as some special Varna. Then that so, like this, it will be changing. Like this, so many Varnas will be manufactured.
Varna Sankara, bro.
That's Varna Sankara. Yeah. Okay, online. Yeah.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, yeah. Like among the scriptures, various scriptures are like quite complex. The Vedas are very complex and all. But here, Mahabharata is glorified in a special way that who else can write Mahabharata other than Narayana? So why Mahabharata is glorified in this special way is my doubt.
Because Mahabharata is such a vast scripture having the 1 lakh slokas. So then that compiling such a scripture is not so easy. So that kind of work can be done by a very great soul only. So
like Vedas are also very vast now, like more vast probably we can say.
Yeah, that's why Vedavyas only can do that.
Yeah.
No others can do.
Sure, Prabhuji, thank you.
Why? How? All now, till now we discussed that. Till now we discussed how the Vedavyas is very special is till now discussed because he did such a magnet. That means even he knows whatever he knows, nobody knows, and whatever knows everything, everyone, that he knows. So, okay. I will try, bro. Yeah, so someone is asking, so the chart for the various other shastras and who compiled. So I will try, and but I am not ready with that. Maybe in future if I get, then I can share. Yes. Okay. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Subhangi Mataji. Okay, you can, class is over, so yeah.
Yes, Prabhuji, I'll write in WhatsApp.
Yeah. You can ask if you want 2 minutes.
Prabhuji, I just wanted to know, you said Krishna Dvaipayana Vyasa himself appears in the 28th cycle of Vaivashvata Manu and writes this. So in other yugas, what about this Mahabharata? Is it not?
Other Vyasas they write. Who are the Jivas?
Okay. But it will not be in the special way like how this is done. Is it so, Prabhuji?
That means, of course, they also follow the same whatever Vyas they did here. So, but they are Avesh Avataras. But here now, in this Dwapara Yuga, Vedavyas is directly Narayana. But in the other Dwapara Yugas, is Avesh Avatara. Jiva is becoming the Vedavyas. And there is Shakti is given, Lord Shakti is given and they are empowered. They can also do because Lord is giving the energy. But here, direct Krishna is, that is the point.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.